We hope that this song is a call to unity.
And Gil, people may know you from your projects in the Portland area and different things that you have in the community. Who knew that you're also in the record business?
Isn't that funny? I started a record label, music publishing company, 15 years ago. This year, actually, 15 years ago. And it's fun because, you know, every now and then you get an artist that actually has something very important to say in addition to just writing good music. And so I was very excited to be able to support and invest my time in these guys.
Well, we do want to show folks, we were able to give the world premiere of the music video during our 6 o'clock news, and we do want to give folks a chance if they missed that. This is your chance to see it now. And then we'll talk more about how the song came to be, how you two partnered up, the lyrics behind it, Carly sings on this, and so how all this came to be. But first, let's take a look now at the video.
Say a prayer for me, I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go through. Say a prayer for me, I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go through.
Yeah, yeah, say a prayer for your mom, cause when you're going through the storm, who's the shot to walk with you with open arms? Say a prayer for your dad, so you can't see how hard it is to be a man in this society. And as we go through these changing times, dear mama, ask that you say a prayer for your kids. Say a prayer, thanks every day you live. Say a prayer for everyone who may have lost someone this year. Let them know that there's a brighter day. And I believe through the dark that someone will come and show them. Cause I know where I came from, I know what I've been through. I've seen the evil man do it, still got a way through. Into the young teen who dreams of a better way. Wants to give up, cause she can see a way. Looking through the maze, you'll be amazed at what you can sustain. Don't worry about it, then you gotta maintain.
Say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go on through. Say a prayer for me, I'll say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go on through, and all will go on through.
We come together, we can do better. So throw your prayers up and throw your cares up and never stop, just like Pac, so keep your head up. And as we bust through these clouds of glass ceilings, these feelings they come across as lost and unappealing. Our reason is at a loss, the cost upon the masses, but we ain't asking, just stop the blasting. And that's to all of our people, the policies of policing, but they can't save us from ourselves, cause only we can truly teach us and reach us. Who you think they trying to beat us? And if we stay divided, they win and they defeat us. Us, to teach us, somebody tell our youth the truth, because they reach in for guns on the corners. They make their mamas, they mourners, and we can only pave the way if we accept what's before us. So black lives matter, and blue lives matter, and all lives matter, then all love matters.
Yeah. I say a prayer for you.
I say a prayer for you.
Say a prayer for us.
And that was the new music video by the local group, Jenna Dean, with the rapper who performed in that, Anthony Raspberry, Gil Holland, who was behind producing the song. And we're so glad to have you guys here with us. We saw that earlier during our 6 o'clock newscast. We wanted to show the people who didn't have the chance to see it earlier, they could see it now on our Facebook Live. And if you're just joining us, thank you for joining us. And we go ahead and invite you to ask some questions to the folks behind the song, promoting peace and unity, nonviolence, certainly important messages in our community right now. And so far, we have about a few thousand people who have been joining us, kind of dipping in and out, which is great. So again, tell your friends if they have any questions, come on and tune into Facebook Live right now. You can watch us, and this is your chance to talk to the artists and those who are behind the song. So I love the video because the message is global. The images that we see in there are global too. So talk to me about how they're overseas images from our backyard, that great mural. So walk us through the different locations that are in the video and what you guys are trying to capture.
Sure. We got a great director, Sam Newton, and he was already going to other countries. He was going to Thailand, he was going to Guam, he was going to Kenya already. And he just said, hey, I love the message that the song is about. If I'm going over there, let me capture some footage of people holding candles and showing again the unity. We always wanted a message that promoted that, and it was just perfect that he was already going. And so we were able to come here and do things here in our hometown in Louisville, Kentucky, and go to some great landmarks as well and show that off for the cities. But again, it doesn't matter if you're in Louisville. It doesn't matter if you're in Greece. We're still human beings. We're all from the same global family, and we have to work together to find solutions.
And some of the sites that we saw in there, we saw, recognized the Big Four Bridge. Mm-hmm. Were you holding a baby on the bridge
too? Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Where'd you pick up a baby? Whose baby
just,
is that?
Perfect handoff. So my wife and I, we have a child. Aww. And so that was her first little cameo.
Oh, baby's first trip on the bridge there in the music video. And was that the Cathedral of the Assumption too?
Yes.
Okay, mm-hmm. And then that great mural where you see the people standing by the candles, Is that local?
That is. It's at Garage Bar. And it's just right there on the side. So it's just a great place that already brings a lot of people together. And Praveen, he was amazing to allow us the space to use right there as well.
And Gil, talk to me about why it was important for you to get involved with this group and this song at this time in the community.
Well, you know, we had a record homicide rate last year. And Jenna Dean, I know the guys in the band kind of separately. And the band formed, 2 years ago? Mm-hmm. And when they were, you know, coming together to go into the studio, I was like, I'd love to help you guys work on a record together. And, you know, Louisville has such an amazing music scene in general. So there's a lot of times it's hard. Like, who do you, you know, you can't sign every single band to your label. But I really just loved what this, you know, it's about diversity. It's about unity. It's about the entire world. And it's about Louisville. I mean, in some ways, the video is a love letter to Louisville. Right? I mean, who doesn't watch that video and feel proud to be a Louisvillian? We're a compassionate city. We're a welcoming city. Mm-hmm. We're a river city, so we've always been open to, you know, new influences. And we've been, you know, generally very embracing of strangers. So I think the song has a good message. The band is a good... lot of good, you know, it's nice to work with people that you actually like and respect.
Yeah. We're showing some of the music video again here, and that's Carly Johnson, who is doing the vocals on this song. Tell us who else is rapping in the video.
It's actually my one of my best friends. His name is Keith Cathy. He works at Mel High School as an assistant. He's assistant AD over there, but also a teacher. We played in a band before called Jamili Brown, and we come from a similar background, so doing good and trying to do what's right, that's part of who we are as individuals. And so it was great to have him come, and he's a former English major, so he knows how to write
this
song.
He's a wordsmith.
He really is. So he did a great job with this song, and it's just great to be able to work with your friends.
Yeah, you talk about similar backgrounds. What is your background?
Born and raised here in Louisville. Went to Mel High School, went to Barrett Mel, went to Bellarmine as well. Got my MBA there. And I love Louisville. I couldn't, for a long time as a young professional, I couldn't wait to leave the city. I just didn't think it wasn't ready at the time. But as I get older, I'm just like, I love this city. I love being here. I love the people. I love the community. And I want to build here as well.
Yeah, and that was important for you with the song?
Absolutely.
So talk to me about the lyrics and how this song came to be.
Yeah. We were playing around with different different ideas for such a long time, but the one overwhelming thing in the song, we knew it was going to be about bringing people together. We have a church choir in there, and so it just naturally sets the mood for the song. And it was pretty easy once we said prayer, it just said, all right, it clicked. And then from there, we just try to create lyrics that, I say a prayer for your mom, because when you're going through the storm, who's the shelter that welcomes you with open arms? And we try to communicate, multiple people from all backgrounds coming together through prayer and through hope. And so it was pretty easy to write at that point.
Well, I'm reading some of the messages here on our Facebook Live here, from some comments from people who are saying the message was strong and I believe it will work. God bless all of you, and just beautiful.
Thank you.
Simply.
Well, we have a lot of challenges in the community. We have a lot of great things happening, but we have to address the challenges head on. And, I think sometimes one person feels like it's too big. It's too, how can I do anything? But, you look at these four or five band members coming together and saying, okay, this is how we can impact Louisville in a positive manner. So I feel like that's also another great thing that you're
Absolutely.
Kind of showing the way. Like, everybody can be part of the solution.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And so for folks who are not familiar with you, Gil, tell us your background.
I grew up in North Carolina and moved here 12 years ago, worked in the Nulu neighborhood for a long time, and then 4 years ago started working to help revitalize the Portland neighborhood. So my office is in the old Boys and Girls Club building on 26th Street and Portland Avenue, and we're fixing up vacant abandoned properties and trying to bring more businesses and, faith-based groups, working with the churches, working with the secular nonprofits, working with some of the cultural institutions, and trying to revitalize, a part of town that has 1,400 vacant abandoned properties. One in four in the Portland neighborhood properties is vacant abandoned.
Yeah. How did you two link up then?
Well, mutual friends.
Mutual friends, yeah.
There's actually a very brief, I heard that they were shooting their first music video like a year and a half, 2 years ago.
Yeah, that's right.
In the Nulu neighborhood. Yeah. And so if you blink, you'll miss me, but I might be in the party scene.
Yeah, he's
definitely there. Was that you?
He's definitely in there.
So you connected through mutual friends, you mm-hmm. came to be. And so when you heard his message and you heard the word prayer, and that just really said, this is it.
Yeah,
this
I was like, and the funny thing is, as a, independent record label, you don't have a lot of money to take ads in Rolling Stone magazine or, so marketing is tight. And so I was like, well, this song, we have to do a video. And then they had this connection with Sam Newton, and he had this great idea for the video. We're like, we love this. Waterfront Park, Big Four, at the end of the day, a bridge is all about bringing people together, mm-hmm. it's connecting people. So there were so many, it just worked on so many levels. It was fun to shoot in the Nulu neighborhood where, my wife and I have done a lot of work, and, it's a great diverse band too. It's like, Jason DeMello, he's actually, he would be here, but he has a teaching gig in California right now.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So it's all people from all over the world coming together to form this one band and then speaking with one voice. And, that's how things happen when lots of people come together and speak with one voice.
It's very powerful for sure. So from here, where do you see things going now? So we've got the music out, it's on social media, it's on the internet. Where do you see the next steps in this process?
Well, we're about to play Waterfront. That's July 4th. We'll be there to do that show. But in between that time as well, we have other songs that we have. One of the songs is called Apathy. We always try to have some type of social message with the music, and if we can align that with the project, then we certainly try to do that as well, because we want the conversation to start. And it doesn't matter if we find the solution now, but at least we can communicate with each other, listen to each other, and really try to find what can we do together. And everyone can be a part of it, as Gil was saying. It doesn't matter if you're a kid, doesn't matter if you're old, doesn't matter your race, we can all be a part of trying to make our community better and working together.
How do you think this is going to connect with the people most in need of hearing this message?
In some ways, I feel like we all just need a hug. We all need one big cathartic hug. And I hope that this song maybe contributes to that. Maybe we'll listen to each other instead of lashing out. And maybe we'll try to build bridges instead of burning those bridges.
Yeah. Gil, what do you think?
Yeah, I mean, we need more hope. And we need, there's a lot of folks in our community who feel disenfranchised. And, if you don't have hope or you don't have good health, you don't have good education, you don't think you have good job prospects, you're more likely to make choices that are going to be detrimental to your and our greater communities. Mm-hmm. Situation. So we want to help provide hope. I think, and the video in and of itself isn't going to solve anything, but maybe the people's reactions to the video will.
Mm-hmm. How so?
No, just coming together and saying, we can do this. We are one Louisville, and if everybody looks at each other's, instead of folks on this side of town looking at folks on that side of town, and it's always that us versus them. Like, we are one community, and how are we going to support our brothers and sisters throughout the community? I mean, that's what it's really about. Like, we are all Louisvillians, and we're a city of neighborhoods, so sometimes people get a little kind of hunkered down in their individual neighborhoods, but we got to think more globally.
Yeah, it's very easy to do. You go to work, you come home,
you're in
you
your
go
bubble.
To your grocery store, you go to your drug store, you go back home. It's easy to do that, yeah. So you're hoping to
Yeah, and you got to break out of mold and meet new people and talk to new people. Because, if you talk to somebody, they're not going to hurt you. You're not going to hurt them.
Yeah.
You're going to feel, if you know people, you're going to feel more for them.
Absolutely.
Talking goes a long way. Well, if you're just joining us now, this is our Facebook Live stream here that we're having our live interview with Gil Holland, who is the producer. And I want to make sure I get the record company.
Technically not producer.
Sorry.
I mean, you were one of the producers.
Okay.
Myself and Jason.
And Kevin Ratterman worked on the, and he's a great producer and musician here in town. And so La La Land is where the little teaser video was shot, and that's where they recorded.
Yep. Okay, and you're with Sonoblast Records, and so you helped to get the record out there then. Okay, and then this is Anthony Raspberry, who raps in the new song that's called Prayer, the music video just debuting today here on our air, so we're glad to have them with us, and they're talking about unity and peace, coming together as one, an important message, certainly, in the community right now, not just in Louisville, but really across the globe. So really important stuff, and we're glad that you have been joining us, and we invite you to ask any questions that you have of the artists and how the song came to be. I like to ask the song of artists of their music. In this song, is there one verse that you love the most that really resonates with you that you think will resonate with the audience?
It's probably Keith. In his last verse, he mentions that he says, if black lives matter, blue lives matter, all lives matter. Mm-hmm. And I think that just really sums up again the unity aspect of it. Obviously, there's so much division about that and those issues, and there are real issues. But at the end of the day, again, I just love how he brought that together and just said it doesn't matter what background you come from, everybody's life is important. And hopefully the streets will hear that, and hopefully communities will hear that everybody's important.
Yeah, that was one of the lines that stuck out to me the very first time I heard it. I was like, I like that one. And the beat is so good, too. Who put the beats together for you?
This is myself. Okay. I sit at the keyboard and Logic and get going. And my band is just great. Jason DeMello on guitar, also producer. Jameson Taylor French, he wrote the chorus, and the beautiful chorus that Carly is singing, amazing. And then John Powell on bass and Joel Goodwin on drums. And so it's a great band, all diverse backgrounds, and it just has... that message it gets across as well.
Yeah, it really is a universal message. And just to let you know, we are reading your comments. So if you have any questions, go ahead. People are saying, I love this Facebook Live. They love the song. They say it's beautiful. They're glad that Louisville's a part of this. And this last person I wrote in saying that I hope the song will heal people. Yeah. And that's really the point.
Yeah, that's the point. And, we think it's also one of those things, again, and thanks to HAS for giving it the world premiere, we really hope that we can be a slow burn. And, now in the music industry, everything's so topsy-turvy and with Spotify and, nobody's buying CDs. But we think this song can be a hit, but we just think it will take 12 months to become a hit because it's going to be word of mouth, people telling their friends.
Right.
If we can provide some healing and solace to some folks, that would be amazing.
Okay, we have to promise us in 12 months when you're like on the Grammys or something, you'll come back, right?
Absolutely.
You'll come
yeah.
back to us.
Absolutely. You guys broke us. We appreciate it.
You got to come back. Don't forget us here.
Not at all.
Well, it's so great. The song is called Prayer. It is on our website right now on WHS11.com, and you can see Doug's full profit report where this music video first debuted during our 6 o'clock news. We're joined by Gil Holland with Sonoblast Records, who helped to make the video and have it become a reality. Anthony Raspberry, who raps on it, and your group is called Jenna Dean, and Carly Johnson, who did the vocals on this. So this is a song that really, it has the great beat, it has the great message, now it just has to reach the right people. And that's always the hardest part of any of these discussions we have about ending violence and creating more unity and having people cross over to other neighborhoods. It's that, get it going, and that's what you guys are trying to do. You're the first people out there with this kind of a song. With, you know, this looks like a video. It could be from any artist who, you know, has been around for 20 years, you know, so it's produced well. And this is something that you guys really want to reach out to people. We have that connection. We're looking at the Big Four Bridge right there. So you know, I'm curious to see how it goes from here, and that the beat is strong, the song is strong, the lyrics are strong. So I'm curious to see where it goes, and, you know, hoping it reaches the right folks.
We love the fact that Sam Newton, you know, he did such a good job directing the video, and the production quality is so good. And then you know, the fact that he was going abroad already, so it looks like we spent so much money on the music right. video, you know, because so we call that production value.
Yeah. Yes.
High production value.
Very much so.
I know. And there
but, you
are.
Know, hopefully, like, the Convention and Visitors Bureau will be like, hey, this is a great way to help promote Louisville, to show Louisville as a compassionate city. Yeah. And then, you know, I love the fact that the video is premiering 2 days after Festival of Faith ends, which brings together all these people from all over the world. You know, everybody needs faith. It doesn't always matter which kind of faith, but people need faith.
Would this be a song you'd be interested in taking, like, into school groups and stuff?
Totally. Yeah. You know, get Anthony to talk about, you know, how, also the creative process, how you write a song. You know, because this has, you know, rap, but then it also has very melodic, you know, orchestral almost parts of it.
We had a chance to, about a few days before recording the video, we went to, I believe it was Shawnee, and we were able to talk to some of the refugee kids there. Mm-hmm. And that was just an amazing experience to talk to them and to hear their questions about America and about Louisville specifically at that. And it was great to be able to tell them that, you know, we are a compassionate city, and, you know, that's something that, you know, starts at the top, starts with the mayor, but it grows with all of us in the city to also be part of that outreach. So it was great to be able to talk to some young students about, hey, you know, you can't have a good future.
Yeah, and to show that you can use your talents for good, which is one of the things, and sometimes we hear, you know, especially rap music, sometimes gets a bad rap, doesn't
Absolutely.
It? But you're showing here that there can be a positive in something that so many people already connect with.
Absolutely.
And music is the universal language, too, so.
Yeah, it really is. And we're looking at some more shots there. This is from the Big Four Bridge, and you've got all kinds. There you are with the baby. Yeah. Now, what's the baby's name?
Her name is Elizabeth.
Elizabeth. Yes. How old is she?
She is 5 months now.
Oh, wow, she's cute.
Thank you.
That's so sweet. Well, next time you have to bring Elizabeth with you so we can
steal the show.
I think she probably will.
She'll try to.
So how did you, yeah, this is the cathedral. This is great access that they had in the cathedral. I didn't know they let you do this.
Yeah, we were very, very, very fortunate to be able to, you know, again, have Gil as a great partner with us and direct, you know, really pushing things ahead for us. And so it was great to have that access and to be able to show off the city. And really, again, even though it has international footage, it's still a very Louisville-centric video. And so it was just amazing to be able to go to these different places and to just maybe show them in a different way. As you said, with rap, it's a little bit different. So really, really amazing experience, though.
And you also think about the cathedral, which only got renovated, 20 years ago. Mm. So, you know, downtown is coming back. So if you think about the video on just an urban renewal, not urban, that has negative connotations, but, you know, a urban revitalization, a lot of the places we shot are places that were in various states of disrepair that have now been beautified, fixed up with a lot of human willpower. people coming together. Mm-hmm. And same with, you know, Garage Bar and
yeah, look at
East
New
Market
Lou,
Street.
You know, how that's come to life.
And then look
life.
At the, look, think about what used to be where Big Four Bridge is, mm-hmm. And now it's beautiful parklands, and that is the community coming together.
Yeah. So. That's really neat. Well, if you're just joining us here, we are talking to Gil Holland with Sonoblast Records, and we're talking to Anthony Raspberry of the group Jenna Dean about their new music video called Prayer, and it is out right now. Now, can folks, they can download this song, right? So is it on, like, SoundCloud? And
it's on SoundCloud, Spotify, mm-hmm. iTunes. If you go to JennaDeanMusic.com, you can go there, and you can get Prayer. You can also hear some other songs as well.
Okay, and the song is all about unity and nonviolence, peace coming together. And you say, though, that most of your songs with the group, it has a message. This mm-hmm. is, they're not party songs.
No. Well, he does have a really good party song. They have a really, really fun party
well,
song.
Well, you can party to them, party yeah. and get a good message at the same time,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, nobody likes to have more fun than we do. But at the same time, again, as artists, I feel like the era of Bling Bling is over. You know, mm-hmm. there's just too much going on, and we have to really dig into these issues and communicate those. So you can still have part, you can still have fun and let your hair down, which is what we love to do still. Mm-hmm. But you got to still understand that you have a responsibility in the community and to yourself as artists, and understand what that means to hopefully, again, bring people together and inspire. So that's what we take seriously as well.
Yeah, I love the in some ways it's like an anti-protest song. Mm-hmm. You know, like in the 60s and 70s, a lot of people were protesting. Mm-hmm. They were like, I have a complaint. And then you have, like, you know, Martin Luther King Jr. saying, I have a dream, right? He was taking it from the positive side as opposed to just talking about the negative and the problems. And I feel like Prayer, you talk about the positivity of coming together. And so in some ways it's a modern 21st century version of a protest song. Mm-hmm. Because you're not talking specifically about all the bad things and how we hate that. You're talking about how we can come together to solve it. So it's, I was thinking about that. Like, that's kind of interesting.
Yeah, that is.
It's the anti-protest,
right?
but conscious song.
Yeah, no, exactly, right? There's some kind of, like, you know, awareness, global, conscious, social awareness that is at play, but it's not like a 70s protest song. Mm-hmm. It's like a come together song. Yeah. So I don't know what that means.
Yeah. It means that you guys have a message that you want people to hear. You want people to connect with what you guys have going on right now. I always like to ask people too, I'm always fascinated by the songwriting process. Mm-hmm. So I envision like a little notebook and like your pencil in the middle of the night just coming up with lyrics. I'm sure it's much more high tech than that now. But tell us, how do you write your songs? You know, like you hear stories about Jay-Z writes stuff on the back of napkins sometimes.
Yeah.
How did you come to write this?
Once the beat is laid, I pass it out to the band. So give it to Jason, give it to Jameson, give it to Joel, give it to JP. Hey, add the bass to it, add the guitar. And when those different instruments are brought in, it'll kind of give you new direction. So you may want to go one way, but then you hear that bass line and it's like, oh, maybe I need to go here. You hear the guitar come over. It's like, and then by the time the lyrics are there, that just really, especially the chorus, that really can push your lyrics for the verses in so many directions. And so for myself, I like to try to write things in my head, because when I go on the microphone, I go to the studio, it's easier to articulate it and it's more powerful. But sometimes you still have to get those napkins out or get your phone out and just like, I just got to put a quick note down quickly. So, but it's a great process, but it really is a teamwork, team building process. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't do it without those guys. I mean, we're all part of this together.
How many versions of it did you have before you said,
how many takes?
This one's it.
We actually got a version of it without Carly. Mm-hmm. The very first version has Jameson singing on top of it and just kind of giving the idea. And so it was great to put it in Carly's hands, mm-hmm. and let her just do her magic, and she just did an amazing job.
She has a great voice.
She does.
Certainly. Yeah. I always wonder, like, now which take is this? Is this like the fifth version of the song here, or is this?
She came in there, she's such a professional, mm-hmm. and it was amazing to be able to say, hey, this is what we want, and then to get her interpretation of it though. And you trust the artist at that point to say, you brought them in for a reason, and you trust them to do what they do, and Carly just did an amazing job.
Yeah. Now, you say you're very socially conscious. So were you always a conscious person and very aware about the social issues, or how did this come to be for you?
It's part of, you know, when you're young, you want to be hard. Every kid does. But as you get older, my mother, she was great. she really installed a lot of those values into us and our church family as well, Greencastle. And
not Greencastle.
Those things stay with you, even if you leave, that foundation is still built. Education has always been important in our household and our family as a whole. So you got to know what's going on in your world. And my mother always allowed me to ask questions, always allowed me to have as many books as I wanted to. And that just allowed me to spread my brain and ask questions and get out there, really want to be conscious about what I'm doing.
So after you got your MBA from Bellarmine, and then you have many other jobs. Musician is your passion and one of your jobs. Mm-hmm. So how did you, though, decide, like, I want to do this? I want to write this song with this message right now in our community?
It's I took a break, and once I got my master's, I went into real estate and really wanted to develop that and build that. But your passions never leave. You can try to walk away from them, but they always have a way of coming back to you. And, you know, just hearing, creating music like this and getting the responses that we've gotten just in the brief time, it really reinvigorates you. It really is great for your spirit.
Mm-hmm. And so, what about you, Gil? Were you always very...
I was an Eagle Scout, so I guess I was, a good Boy Scout. You know, I grew up in a very small town, Davidson, North Carolina, so there's like 2,000 people. Mm-hmm. So when you're that close-knit a community, you know everybody, and if somebody's hurting, you reach out, because you are everybody, you know, everybody is neighbors. And so I feel like Louisville's in some ways a bigger version of that, and certainly the Portland neighborhood is very much like my hometown of Davidson. So I was always involved, but I also just love music and, you know, love the arts. And I think the arts are a great equalizer. And Louisville, one of the reasons I wanted to move to Louisville is because we have an amazing art scene and there's amazing creative people. It's, you know, it's a relatively inexpensive place to live. So you have all these amazingly creative people that have time and bandwidth. And you said, spread your mind. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like you spread your brain and you can create, you can work. You know, there are a lot of people work in restaurants. You work a couple nights a week and then have a lot of time to create. I mean, I lived in New York City. It's like I had to work 80 hours a week just to pay the rent. Right. And I, you know, I still, you know, had eviction tape on my door one time. So it's like, you know, there's some challenges. So Louisville is an amazing place for the creative.
Yeah, it's a good place to spread your brain and spread your mind, open your mind to new ideas. So we're here now talking with Anthony Raspberry and Gil Holland with Sonoblast Records. Anthony's with the group Jenna Dean, and they have a new song out called Prayer that hopes to have a strike a chord with a lot of people. And I know our director Maxwell's in there. Could we play the music video again if people are just joining us on our Facebook live stream? All right, let's listen to the video. It's called Prayer, Jenna Dean featuring Carly Johnson.
Say a prayer for me, I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go through. Say a prayer for me, I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go through.
Yeah, yeah, say a prayer for your mom, cause when you're going through the storm, who's a shot to walk with you with open arms? Say a prayer for your dad, so you can't see how hard it is to be a man in this society. And as we go through these changing times, dear mama, I ask that you say a prayer for your kids. Say a prayer, I thanks every day you live. Say a prayer for everyone who may have lost someone this year. Never know that there's a brighter day, and I believe through the dark that someone will come and show the way. Cause I know where I came from, I know what I've been through. I've seen the evil man do it, still got a way through. Into the young teen who dreams of a better way, wants to give up cause she can see a way. Looking through the maze, you'll be amazed at what you can sustain. Don't worry about the things you gotta maintain.
I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go on through. Say a prayer for me, I say a prayer for you, say a prayer for us, and all will go on through.
prayers up and throw your cares up and never stop just like Pac, so keep your head up. And as we bust through these clouds of glass ceilings, these feelings they come across as lost and unappealing. Our reason is at a loss, the costs upon the masses, but we ain't asking to stop the blasting. And that's to all of our people, the policies of policing, but they can't save us from ourselves, cause only we can truly teach us and reach us. Who you think they trying to beat us? And if we stay divided, they win and they defeat us. From preachers to teachers, somebody tell our youth the truth, because they reaching for guns on the corners. They make their mamas they mourners, and we can only pave the way if we accept what's before us. So black lives matter, and blue lives matter, and all lives matter, and all love matters.
I say a prayer for you.
I say a prayer for you.
Say a prayer for us.
A candle loses nothing by lighting another, which is a great line that you guys end the music video with. You just saw the music video for the new song that's called Prayer. It's by Jenna Dean, featuring Carly Johnson on vocals. Anthony Raspberry was in there rapping. That was him performing. And Gil Holland, who's with Sonoblast Records, was the executive producer for this song. So tell us, for the folks who are just joining us on our Facebook live stream, how this song came to be and how you two hooked up.
Sure. You know, just with the band and writing new songs for the EP that we have coming out later on with Sonoblast Records. And this is one of the songs that we just really kept drawing us back to it. We didn't have any words for it for a long time, but once we found the hook, we just knew exactly what we had to talk about and really try to unify our community and what's going on with everything happening in the world. How can we try to put music out there that inspires individuals and, again, works to bring people together?
Was there one event that happened in the city where you kind of said, okay, this is it, I got to do something?
You know, we've been, as Gil mentioned earlier, there's the levels of violence, just overall, it's just disgusting. And as we're human beings, we're not animals. And so we just can't stand by any longer and just watch what's going on and just sit on the couch and, that's terrible. We need to find ways to get out there and try to find solutions. And so just really watching the violence in our city, but also on a national level as well. And there's so many great people in this city that want to help and that want to be a part of something large. This is Compassionate City. This is the land of Ali. We take that very seriously.
Yeah. And Gil, for you, how did you connect with Anthony, and why was this project so important to you?
Yeah, well, I loved the you know, Jason DeMello, who's in the band, plays guitar. He's also was getting his master's at University of Louisville in the entrepreneurship program, or PhD, mm-hmm. yeah. And so, you know, being involved in the entrepreneurial community, I kept talking to Jason. Jason was like, oh, you know, I'm in this band. And then at one point they were like, do you want to come play guitar on a track at this party? And I'm like, I have not played guitar in public for 20 years. And, but it was a Neil Young song, so it was easy enough. I could do the three chords. It was three chords. And so literally one thing led to another. And then he's like, we got some music. I met Anthony, met the rest of the band. You know, it just seemed like a perfect fit. You know, so it's like, I always say it's like dating or falling in love. Sometimes it just hits you and you're like, I have to work with this band. Yeah. I love this band. I love the song, you know. And my kids, my wife, Augusta, we have watched this video so many times and it doesn't get old. And I feel like that's also the great test of a good piece of art, is that you can look at it a million times, you can read it, it's like a good movie, you can watch it. I mean, you know, think of some of your favorite movies, how many times you watch your favorite songs, how many times you watch this on YouTube, you know. So I'm just excited to be part of this project.
Was there something that...
I'm a fan.
Yeah, you're a fan. Was there something in particular, though, that really struck you in our community that made you say, okay, this is the right song, the right time, the right message?
Yeah, well, we actually, I mean, we've had this video for, when did we finish, like 2 months ago?
Yeah.
I mean, I've been so anxious to get it out because, you know, 2 months ago was a good time, too. You know, when you look at the homicide rates and, you know, whether it's related to income inequality at the national and local level, income disparities, if it's the health, if it's the drug crisis, whatever it is, there are serious issues. And, you know, how can the arts come together and help make the city a greater place? And, you know, the Fund for the Arts, and there's a great arts cultural plan that just got released, Greater Louisville Arts Cultural Plan 2020, and it's all about access and making sure everybody has access to the arts, because, you know, if you are a kid and you have arts in your life, you are more likely to have be gainfully employed as an adult. You know, so there's just all these things that work together: health, arts, public safety, you know, vacant abandoned properties, parkland, like you saw the Big Four Bridge, and you know, the amazing work Waterfront Development Corporation's done.
And the song is available now. It's called Prayer.
Yes.
By Jenna Dean. It's available on the usual Spotify,
iTunes,
SoundCloud. You can get it anywhere right now.
Absolutely.
And tell me, for you, where do you see this going from here? Where do you see this is a great message, well-produced video, great song? What do you want to see happen next and come from your hard work on this project?
Well, this is just the beginning for us as far as starting the conversation. So the video is one part of that. The mural that you see, that's a garage bar, that's part of it as well. That's the physical embodiment of it. We invite people to go down there and share their stories, things that they need a prayer of. You know, feel free to, you know, we hope that people will share, you know, their needs and their wants. Because again, as I said before, we feel like people need to heal. This community needs to heal. And so maybe we can share, you know, what we're hoping for and what our prayer is, but put that to action. Faith without works is dead. So let's go out there and put our boots to the streets and get something done.
And Gil, what do you think will really resonate with people from all walks of life, all corners of this community?
Yeah, well, I think, you know, it starts with that it's a great song. Right. And so I think, you know, great movies that are great movies. And then after you watch the movie, you're like, you realize, wait a minute, there was a message there, you know. And I think this is one of those songs you're like, first you listen, and you're like, that's just a great song. I want to hear it again. And then you start listening to the words, and you're like, so it makes you think. And, you know, I think we need to do a little more thinking and coming together and hugging, like Anthony said.
Hug it out.
Hug it out.
That's what he said. The community just needs a big hug.
Yeah, the next song is going to be called Hug.
But you said some of your other music, though, does have a message, socially conscious message.
Yes. We wrote another song called Apathy, and that was after listening to the Pope. He was talking about, he did a homily, and it was just talking about our apathetic nature in the world today. And so listening to that, it just really struck me to think about what we do. You know, with so much death, it's like we're almost okay with it and we just accept it. Mm-hmm. But we're in charge of our communities and we're in charge of ourselves. We can do something. We just have to have the will to do it. And you know, so apathy tackles that situation. But we still like to have fun too, don't get me wrong. So we have a few songs on there where, you know, you can put your dancing shoes on and get out there.
Yeah. And what do you think it will take, guys? What will it take? This is your way of contributing a possible solution and a conversation. But what do you think it will take to really bring us together and get to the point where we can get past some of the issues, most notably recently, the violence that we've seen in the community?
I personally believe it's going to take an intellectually honest conversation, because only by getting to the truth can we see the interconnectivity of it all. You know, drugs don't just affect the inner city, they also affect the suburbs, and we see that with the crisis happening, the pain pills right now. Mm-hmm. Lack of education doesn't just affect the poor community, it also affects all of us when you talk about job retainment, attraction and growth. So all these issues are truly interconnected with one another, and the more we begin to understand that, the faster we understand that, we can then create solutions based upon that.
I'm looking at some new messages that are just coming in here. One person wrote, I'm proud of these fellas. Shirley Higby says, beautiful song. Ellen Guilford says, wow. I mean, wow, what an awesome song. And the voices, this gives me goosebumps. I love it. I want to share this song. You guys and gal rock. Olga Maria Cruz wrote, love the message of solidarity and humility and connection to the divine. Curious to hear more about the development of the idea to expand from Louisville to images of people in other countries and images of other cultures. Thanks for the live posting of this interview. So, well, Olga Maria Cruz, thank you for checking out our Facebook feed. And we want to touch on that issue, though. So how, because she asked the question, you're just curious to hear more about the development of the idea to expand from Louisville to images of people across the country. So talk to us about how that global image is connected to us here at home.
It was really great, because that was always at the inception of the video, we wanted to tie in the unity aspect, and so we were trying to figure out the different ways to do that. And so we put out a filler to a few directors, and Sam Newton's from LA, he got wind of it, and he was already going to different countries and said, hey, you know, I really love the message. If I'm going over there, let me just go ahead and gather some shots while I'm there. And it just really, you can see in the video, really adds to it, and it says, hey, it's not just about the local community, it's about the global community. And again, showing that different faces, we're all going through the same things. We all want good health, we all want education, we all want safety. It doesn't matter where you are. And that's really everybody's part of the global prayer in a lot of ways.
Yeah. And we could have shot a lot of those shots in Louisville. Yeah. You know, we have such a great refugee and immigrant community. We do some work with Kentucky Refugee Ministries. So that, you know, it was always like, let's have a diverse music video. I mean, you know, it's a pretty diverse band.
Yeah, yeah. So
it was always part of the idea.
To have that kind of, not to be as inclusive
yeah,
as possible.
Exactly.
Well, the song is called Prayer. Jenna Dean featuring Carly Johnson, and of Jenna Dean, Anthony Raspberry, who does some of the rapping in the song. He is joining us now. Gil Holland, who is the executive producer of the song with Sonoblast Records, based in the Portland community. And your work in the Portland community, has that kind of helped? Do you think ultimately this is all fitting together? It seems like these pieces are all coming together in your life.
Yeah, well, you know, it's all about community building at the end of the day. And, you know, the Portland neighborhood's the most diverse, racially diverse neighborhood in Louisville, 35% African-American, 65% Caucasian, at least top two most diverse neighborhoods. And, you know, there's got lots of great history. And, you know, I feel like as the country becomes kind of more diverse, mm-hmm. The Portland neighborhood, you know, it's not like there's interracial violence. You know, we can be a beacon to show the rest of the community how everybody can live together in peace and, you know, peaceful harmony. It's not just some lofty idea that people talk about. It is attainable.
It is.
It's possible.
Yeah.
And that's what this song is about, the message of possibility, the message of hope, and saying that this can happen. We can bring it together, right?
We can. I mean, I'm no hippie per se,
yeah, right?
You know,
but we're a small enough community too. You know, we're small enough that I think that, you know, everybody is one, maybe two people away from the people in control or the people in power. Nobody is so far outside of the greater community. So, you know, I lived in New York City. It's like, you know, I never met the mayor in New York, and you know, Mayor Fisher's in our music video. Actually, I did meet the mayor was. But that was 12 years, 13 years in Manhattan. And, you know, so it's like, you know, that's a huge town, 14 million people. You know, it's a little harder to think that one person can make a difference in that great a community. But I think in Louisville, you know, you look at all the good works that a lot of people are doing, and, you know, one person can make a difference in Louisville.
It's that ripple effect that you're hoping. If the folks that are like me that are watching us on this Facebook live stream, we played the video a couple of times for you, and I just, the song, it's going to be in my head all night, which is a good thing, because if people go out and they're humming the song. What are you humming? Oh, it's the song I heard. And that's where that ripple effect comes in. Absolutely. And people will not just hear the beat, you say, then eventually come back and hear the message. Right. So if folks want to reach out to you guys, if they have, I assume you're on all the social media.
Absolutely.
Things. Okay. Yeah. All the social media
you can imagine.
Apps and everything.
Anthony did turn off his phone for the Facebook Live because he was, you know, worried it was going to blow up.
Yeah. This is a lot of emails.
But afterwards, they can find you on Facebook. Is it just Anthony Raspberry?
They can, Jenna Dean.
Jenna Dean, okay.
And then JennaDeanMusic.com has more music, has some essays, and we're just trying to, we're trying to build community within the website as well. So that would take time, but this is the first call that we're doing with people. So we encourage you to come back over and over as we continue to build.
Is your website just JennaDean.com?
JennaDeanMusic.com.
JennaDeanMusic.com. Yes. Okay, that's where you can find them. The song is called Prayer. Anthony Raspberry with Jenna Dean. Gil Holland, who is the executive producer on the song with Sonic Blast Records. We thank you guys for joining us. And before we leave, let me just check and see if there's any more questions on there, because we want to include you guys, because we thank you for watching. Lots of you guys have checked us out here over the past hour, so we do thank you for that. Just going to refresh the computer real quick to see if there's any other additional questions before we leave you here this evening. I think those were the questions we had. But continue the conversation online right now. Continue the conversation on Facebook. You can reach out to them. You can download the song. And we have played it for you here. The song is available on our website. You can listen to it on our Facebook page. You guys have it up on YouTube.
Send the YouTube link to your friends that don't live in Louisville, and maybe they'll want to move here.
Hey.
We want to be part of economic development for the city.
There you go.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, thank you guys so much.
Thank
you. Thank you for joining us on our Facebook Live. Have a great night, everyone.